All right, everybody, it is the time of year where you guys write hate comments tell us how dumb we are. It is our annual bust slash overvalued. Some of these guys are probably gonna have pretty good years, but based where they're going in drafts, we think it's a little too high.
That's all we're saying.
That's all we're saying. I don't know how to be any clearer. Dustin, we have a draft guide. Tell them how to get it.
In the description, find the link, takes you to the draft guide. We update it throughout the preseason as stuff happens, and it's free. What's not to like about that? It's got our top 150 cheat sheet on it. Check it out. Download it.
All right. First guy I'm going to. He's going to pick 84. That is Mr. Will Fuller of the Texans. Yes, he could have a very solid year. We do like that offense. However, in seven games last year, 500 yards, four touchdowns. Why did he only play seven games? Well, he tore his ACL in October. Should be ready for the start of the year, but a guy that works on speed, separation, tearing an ACL, just makes us a little bit nervous. That's why he's on this list. We wouldn't necessarily take him around pick 80. You know, Hopkins obviously there, he's a target monster, they have Cutie there. And it's just tough, that's all that we're saying. If he slips in drafts, I'll gladly take him. Just probably not at his average draft position.
Mike Williams is next. Ooh. And I know he's everyone's darling heading into this year, wide receiver. Currently about the 64th pick, 24th wide receiver. I get it. The guy had double-digit touchdowns. But when you really dig into the stats, it gets a little scary. He only had 66 targets. Excuse me. Only 43 of those ended up being catches. That just scares me a little bit. He's not getting enough looks. On that offense, yes, I do think he'll get more looks this year. But if Keenan Allen stays healthy...
Which he will.
I just don't see enough targets to go around for Williams to take a huge jump this year. I think he will have some amazing years. I'm just not thinking it's quite yet. I think he's still a year or two away. So, I don't know. The targets scare me.
All right, let's keep that hate train going. Derrick Henry. And if you won the championship last year, he might be a big reason why. And he's going to pick 33, 17th running back off the board. Here's the deal with Derrick Henry. He's already banged up, so that makes a little bit nervous. He doesn't catch the ball because Deion Lewis is there, and Deion Lewis ain't going anywhere. He's still going to catch it. And if you really look at the numbers, he had about 1,000 yards and 12 touchdowns. He got about 450 of those and six touchdowns in just two games. So he really, I mean, the one was that Jacksonville game, I think, but he was like, he destroyed it in a couple games, really helped his stats. Now they happen to be like championship weeks for most people in fantasy, so you really remember how great he did. It's just, it's a buyer beware type of situation. He's had so many games. We've always loved Henry. We always waited for him to blow up, and it just never really happened. Things haven't changed that much. He's going to be solid, but Deion Lewis is still there. Pick 33, a little too high for us.
Dante Moncrief is next for me, and I get it. Whoever ends up being the true, you know, wide receiver two fantasy-wise out there with Pittsburgh is going to have a lot of value. Our money is just a little bit more on Washington, but I do think Moncrief's going to be out on the field a lot, but I don't necessarily think that's going to translate into fantasy gold. He's currently being taken around the 153rd pick, wide receiver 55, so you're not paying a huge price tag for him, but I would rather take a gamble on a younger guy with a higher upside. Moncrief's been in the league for five seasons, and he's been on high-powered offenses, and his best season is 64 catches, 733 yards, and six touchdowns. And to me, that's what I think about what he does this year. I'd rather take a gamble on a young guy that could blow up. I'm ignoring Moncrief for the most part.
Another guy that's not so young anymore is Devin Funchess. He's still on the younger side, but I remember coming to the league, we're like, oh, this guy's got the body of a tight end, he's going to be a beast, and now he's going over the Colts, so there's a lot of people really excited about that, but still T.Y.'s there, and just because he's playing with Andrew Luck doesn't mean he's just going to blow up. In the first 4 years of Funchess's career at Carolina, he played in about almost 16 games, it was like 14 through 16 every single year, and his career average is 558 yards and five touchdowns a year.
It's not that good.
Yeah, are we really thinking he's going to double that up and, you know, be a 1,000-yard, you know, 10-touchdown guy? I don't think that's going to happen all of a sudden just because Andrew Luck's throwing the ball. Even though we both believe Andrew Young is a potential MVP guy, just, I'm not fallen that much in love with Funches. That's all.
Julian Edelman's my next guy.
Oh, breaks my heart.
Wide receiver 16.
Breaks my heart.
ADP 41. Currently going over a lot of big names. I get it. Gronk's gone. Everyone's like, oh, here we go. Gronk's gone. Edelman's going to go nuts. I don't think that's the case. And let's not forget, Edelman has a very extensive injury history. He's been in the league for 9 seasons. He only has, you know, for a PPR guy, he only has over 100 catches one time in his career. Twice, he's only been over 1,000 yards twice. He's never had more than 7 touchdowns. He's a steady Eddie guy. He's going to be a solid PPR guy. But at that point in the draft, I want potential top 10 value guy. And you're not going to get that out of Edelman. I'm looking for a higher upside guy at that point in the draft.
I want to remind everybody that some of these guys we're just saying are going a little too high for us.
That's all we're saying.
That's all we're saying. We might like them, but there might be some other factors at play. And that's the case for Mr. Nick Chubb of the Cleveland Browns. I know. And we both like him.
We
both like him. Going around pick 17 right now. But there's the Hunt factor in play. So let's talk about what he did last year. He had almost 1,000 yards, 8 touchdowns. It's, you know, that's why he's getting drafted where he is. It's very viable he's going to do it again. Everybody thinks the Browns are going to be this amazing offense, which could be the case. But you got to remember, Hunt is there. So after 8 games, he is going to start splitting carries to a degree. And let's play this out. Let's say they're in the playoff hunt. They're looking pretty good. First of all, the Browns are going to see what they got with Hunt, so they're going to definitely work him in with that. Let's say they start to lock up a wild card spot. All of a sudden, towards the end of the year, you might be resting Chubb a little bit and letting Hunt run a little bit more, because that's not going to hurt the Browns for their playoffs. Who knows it's going to hurt you and your playoffs. And I know that's looking a little, that's looking far in advance, but just when you're in that, you know, if it's a coin toss kind of thing, you're between him and like Mixon or Connor even, you know, that's why we got those kind of guys ranked over him. It's just, they feel safer. There's just
We play for championships.
Play for the Dubs.
We play for championships. Freeman for Atlanta is next. RB15
going up. We got some big names this year.
ADP 30.
Scary.
And again, we play for championships. And Freeman, if you've ever owned him, he is one of the most frustrating guys. He is always have these little nagging injuries. And it's just, I just think people are so excited about Tevin being gone that they're forgetting how annoying Freeman is to own. And it's not like he has that much talent behind him that's really going to be pushing him. I don't mind Ito Smith, but you know, I do think Freeman will probably get more touches, but can he handle more touches? Can he be out on the field? And he is only a career 4.3 yards per carry guy, so if they're really pounding him, I just think there's less likely of a chance that he's going to stay healthy. I think there's a, you could argue that Coleman leaving actually hurts Freeman because there's less chance he'll be there at the end of the year. So he scares me a little bit.
All right, Vance McDonald. The Pittsburgh Steelers. They love him. He's sleeper. You know, he had his best
Browns
year
gone.
He's ever had. And Brown's gone. Got that right there on the notes, Dustin.
Hey, I don't want to chime in.
But best year he ever had in his 6 years last year. It was an amazing year. 50 catches, 600 yards, and 4 touchdowns. But Brown's gone, right? All of a sudden, there's all these targets. He's going to do so much better. That's not the case. That's not how the Steelers' offense rolls. With Brown being gone, Juju's going to get a bump. Whoever the number two is going to fall into the Juju. They're still going to give Connor a bunch of touches and a bunch of yards. Again, just everybody's loving him as a sleeper. Pick 100, and it keeps going. It keeps getting better and better and better. For tight ends this year, you're getting one of those top three, or you're waiting. If he slips, which he isn't the one that's slipping, that's when you can grab him. So the other tight ends are slipping, grab them. I just don't think Vance McDonald's got the chance to like have a blow-up season. Like, he could probably be solid, but we got him on the bus because I don't think that blow-up's happening.
Alshon Jeffrey is my last guy out there with the Eagles. Wide receiver 29 off the board, ADP right around pick 70. I get it. He's Alshon Jeffrey. He's, you know, big body receiver. Everyone loves him. But he hasn't had over 1,000 yards since 2014. They got DeSean Jackson back. They got Ertz. They got Aguilar. They got Goddard. There's no reason for them to really force feed Alshon. I think his best days are very much behind him. And again, a lot with these other guys, there's other players at that point in the draft that are more exciting, have higher upsides. I'm letting someone else draft what I would say just the name of Alshon Jeffrey.
Yeah, I think he'll be a better real football player than fantasy. Like, it'll be better for the Eagles, so they will spread it around.
It's very distracting when you're trying to talk and someone's making a paper
but
football
it's be,
next to you.
It's a paper
or
airplane.
Or paper airplane next to you.
Do you want to launch it?
No. Go ahead.
You
sure?
You
distracted me. Now let me see this amazing airplane. It was terrible.
Damn
that
it.
That was so bad.
Ah!
Bad. Check out our all-around